Have you ever spent hours trying to figure out how to add specific keywords to a product description in a way that sounds natural because you need your product to rank for that keyword? Truth is, you don't need to, and really you shouldn't stuff every single keyword that you want to rank for in your product descriptions. That's what backend keywords are for. I'm Manuela with Plytix, and we've created this YouTube channel to help small and medium-sized businesses sell better so that you can compete with e-commerce giants. If you want to learn more about Plytix, then check out the video that I'm including in the description below. In order for your product to rank on Amazon and for shoppers to find them, you need to incorporate keywords into your product listing. Most of these keywords are included in the front end part of your listing. This would be the part that's visible to shoppers, like the product title, the featured bullet points, product descriptions, and images. But there's also something called back-end keywords. Back-end keywords are hidden keywords. These are keywords that aren't visible to shoppers who visit your product page, but they are crawlable, meaning that the Amazon algorithm will be able to pick up on them, know that these keywords are relevant to your product listing, and will rank your product accordingly. To understand why you should use backend keywords, you need to understand a little bit about product listing optimization. Product listing optimization, or PLO, is the process of optimizing your listings to increase traffic and conversion. When optimizing your product listings, you need to include keywords for SEO purposes, which covers the traffic problem. But you also need to make your title and your product description engaging and readable for shoppers in order to drive conversions. Amazon itself states that using backend keywords allows sellers to create engaging and readable content for a product page while still ensuring that Amazon indexes all the keywords relevant to the product. What they mean by this is that in order to have a truly great product listing, you need to include keywords in a way that sounds natural and engaging to your shopper. Let's look at some examples. Imagine that you're selling a laptop sleeve. There are so many keywords that you can rank for. Laptop sleeve, laptop case, computer bag, computer carrying case, computer sleeve, and so on. Now imagine looking at a product listing that just regurgitates random keywords or repeats them over and over. For example, one with the title, 15-inch laptop computer sleeve carrying case bag. And a description that reads, this is the most durable computer case on the market. If you're looking for the most durable laptop sleeve for your 15-inch computer, then this laptop sleeve is perfect. This is a water-resistant laptop sleeve that's very durable and is the best laptop case for any computer up to 15 inches, whether it's a Dell, Lenovo, Apple MacBook, HP, or any other. I don't know about you, but I see red flags all over that listing. By incorporating backend keywords, you can add up to 250 bytes of keywords that you won't need to include in your product descriptions in order to rank. So for example, we can clean this title and description up to be more reader-friendly. Something to keep in mind is that you shouldn't be using the same keywords in both your front-end descriptions and your back-end search terms. Use your Amazon descriptions and featured bullet points to cover primary competitive keywords that are relevant to the topic and the audience, and save your secondary keywords for the back-end. That way you can get a chance to rank for both. To include back-end keywords, head to your Amazon Seller Central account. Under Inventory, go to Manage Inventory and find the listing that you want to add the backend keywords to. Click Edit and select the Keywords tab. Under Search Terms, enter the keywords that you want to add and click Save. Is there anything else you want to know about backend keywords or any other e-commerce topic? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos like this. I see red flags all over that.
Okay, I'm gonna start again and then we can
Okay.
Like, I don't know.